Yeah. Yeah. Oh, look right now. Yeah. Ooh, hold up. Yeah. Ooh. What you know about Glock 9, boy? What does this mean?
The clock has stopped with one minute remaining, and you still have 12 yards to go. You'll need a touchdown here to win the game. The offense needs a conversion here, fourth down. One last throw here for Newton. Buying time is left. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the line.
I have to pass him.
The results you wanted, but the good news, practice makes perfect. We'll see you again right here.
Oh, pass. You gotta pass it. Oh, shit. I didn't read that.
And this offense getting ready as they're looking for a fourth down conversion.
Damn, let me take a sip of this water, you know what I'm saying?
Come back, try again.
Now that's some good ass water, you know what I'm saying? There you go. Easy. Give me that money. Give me them coins. Give me them Bobby. Give me that coin. Yeah. Give me that Molly. Give me your toys. Yeah. Give me that Molly. Fucking Molly. You know that Molly? I'm off that Molly. Fucking bitch. I'm fucking. Y'all. Fuck your bitch. She sucked this dick. Yeah. On that Molly. You know, Molly. Up in Cali, taking Miley. Oh, what's up, Dallas? Oh, shit, what's up, Dallas? Congratulations, you're watching my master update from the other budget. I'm not gonna screen clip on my YouTube. Okay. Captain upgrading it back. More. Damn, this just give you 25. That's not a lot at all. Dang, how many points? Allow 5. Let me go upgrade Ryan Shazier real quick. See what's up. Hey, that's still something real, bro. This should take too long, though. I have like three. I have one. What the fuck? That's too many right now. That's too many fucking things. I'll do that shit later. Not worth my time right now. Yo.
Bears Indian agreed to a record setting 6-year, $141 million extension with $90 million. That's too much, bro. That's.
Damn. Fuck to this. Oh my god, dude.
Oh, well, what can we do?
In the chain, bust down wrists, and
Apparently, I'm only getting a token. And okay, guys, there you go.
Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando. I'm the coach, and this is Matt Ultimate Team.
Get the money to the top, never stop.
The Texans offense ready for first and 10. Back to throw. Dumps it complete to Miller. Finding room to the 20 and down to the 16-yard line. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first down now with that clock rolling. Spike will come with 34 seconds to go.
Put the money to the top, but it's stop. If you can go. No. Ya los puse ahí. El rojo nomás. El rojo nomás. El rojo nomás.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down.
Oh shit, it's third down. It's third down. Good.
He's back to throw. And he'll get it down this time.
There you go.
To 17.
There you go. Push it.
Fourth down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout. As they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game.
Let's go. Not happening. Let's go. All the way back. You know I don't have to. All the way back, I don't have to. Shit, man. Get the money to the top. Never stop.
That was an absolutely monstrous big play right there. Backs to the wall. The offense has it in the red zone. Driving for the winning score. And he says, not on my watch. And that is one happy bunch on the sidelines.
A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because...
Expander. Yeah. Okay. What did you do? The hell? Just throw something?
Hey, welcome in everyone to another edition of the NFL.
Make me.
And the Colts offense ready here for first and 10.
Nope. Maybe.
He'll look to throw. Too flat. That's complete to the running back. Now a loose football. The ball comes out. Now the Colts moving quickly here in the hurry-up offense.
Pussy.
And with the clock ticking under 50 seconds now, he spikes it.
Yeah.
They've been really good, converting 7 of their 10 tries. This will be 3rd and 6.
Pussy. Where are you going? Boy, if you don't get your stank ass, I'm running right now. But I'm already in your lobby. Nah, I'm really coming. No, like, I'm dead ass coming. Like, I have 30 seconds left. This is my last solo challenge. So I'm coming. What? Alright, then get off Fortnite.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Why not?
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective,
taking
care of the ball is so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
Because why, dude?
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, just us against the world and get it done.
I remember a coach at a previous stop tell me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. And they did in this one. Well, as always, partner, an extreme pleasure to share a booth with you. I have to say, I am impressed at your discipline because you came here and you said you were not going to eat any of the media buffet. You made it to the end. You didn't consume a single calorie.
I appreciate that. What you missed is me going to the concession stand outside of your eyesight and getting it done that way. Look, I mean, they were serving the good stuff. I had to do it.
Oh, man, but you're svelte, in good shape. But
KJ, we playing? What's up? KJ. Boy, Dallas, you don't get your stank ass back. KJ. Are we playing or what's up? Dallas, I'm about to eat your ass. Are we playing or what's up, KJ? Dallas. Alright, KJ, are you playing? See, Dallas, it is you, stupid cunt. Alright, I take that as a no then. Bruce Wayne, I'm Batman. Yeah. I go to hotels when I step out, yeah, your boy got a doorman. I go to nightclubs for the, yeah, they call me the madman. I ain't no madman, I just go crazy, man. Go hard, can't face, man. The choppers, rip wasteland. This what happens when you give it a taste life and you give it a wasteland. Give it a fake life and then the ape, man. Place a geometry dash while I wait. No, I already passed this level. Fuck. Oh, bitch, I already passed this level. I'm not this one. I'll try one of the harder ones. I'm gonna put X dead. Oh shit. Okay, I understand. Bitch. Alright, jump.
This is the NFL.
Oh, what the fuck?
We're just about set to get started, and this ought to be a good one.
This ought to be a good one. Yeah. Hold on, this shit gotta wait. I gotta pass this level. Shit. Yeah, that shit hard as fuck. I'm not doing that shit. What the fuck?
The Titans offense set to spank go ass up. First and 10. This is Lewis. Oh no, he lost the football.
Damn. Now we got no one to fucking pick that shit up. With the money to the top, man, it's top.
But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes.
Oh no, he lost the football.
Dude, that's two fumbles in a row. I'm gonna touch that shit. God, it's just a shit to bitch ass up.
So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football.
Come on, bitch. It's such a pussy ass up.
It definitely was because that's all okay, defense is talking about.
Pussy, getting the football and either advancing the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. Oh no, he lost the football. There we go. 3-0. Let's go. Tavion Smith.
So much for the 4-minute offense. They were trying to reduce the clock.
Tavion Smith.
And leave no time for them to come back and catch him. And guess what? They turned the ball over. Yeah, I mean, they had it all set up for themselves, and they let it go.
There's a touchdown right here. First play. Actually, no, I'm going to just run it. That's like a waste of time. There you go.
Lines up a decent run, and it also takes us to the 2-minute warning. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. So the Steelers
on the ball, on the ball.
As we get you reset, and let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. This is Ajayi.
Moves
the chains.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Facts.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run.
Running shit on him. Yeah.
And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As they stop it here with a minute 7 remaining.
Get him with a counter. I think you got him with the L2. The L2 circle right here. L2 circle. Yeah.
Stops short of the 25, but that's second effort. Got him a couple extra.
Hit him with a nice jump there on the play action. Push shot.
It's second and four.
despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid game.
Yeah, circle will track to the most likely circle. I don't know, much like a triangle.
Spacing and run fits, and those creases like they were able to exploit right there.
And this is going to be caught. Yep. He got it. It's a touchdown. Forget overtime.
Jerry Rice, let's get it.
I don't know how many more of these my heart can take, my man. I just don't know. Another big touchdown late in the game. They look like they're in control.
I still have to upgrade Jerry Rice. What the fuck am I doing?
Block the extra point, go down and score, kick the extra point themselves. They can pull this one out.
Yeah, but also on the sideline that just took the lead, you got to get your defense ready and the special teams unit for the kickoff coming up.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Got to pull everyone together and make sure they're still focused and aren't already celebrating the win.
He'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards up to the 27.
Put the money to the top, never stop. We should wait, put Khalil Mack all the way out here.
Now Mario,
you put him all the way out so you can get the pressure. Put the interception. GG's.
There as it's intercepted. Vernon Hargraves with a pick. Matthews, the intended GG's. Target. Well, when someone other than the quarterback is throwing the football, it's either beautiful or a disaster, and here it was the latter.
Nowhere in between, right? You're exactly right. It takes some fortitude to call that type of a play, but when it doesn't work, oh boy, you wish you hadn't.
Well, I know the points in this when you wanted to close your eyes. Because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball.
Hey everybody, it's the coach here in Orlando, getting you set for this.
And now the offense will look to convert on third down. They run with a giant. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. The bottom line is he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep him.
Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. 20, 10, 5. Deep into Jacksonville territory. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down.
I'm a little surprised right here. They've got 3 timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
And he's across for the touchdown, and it's likely the game winner.
Easy.
Here in the closing stages.
So for those of little faith, guess what?
It got done. They now have the lead with that touchdown this late in the contest. I wonder if that was a play they were holding or a play that they just knew would work from past experience.
Well, I just saw it in their eyes on the sideline before starting that last drive, and they did. You're right. They got it done. Looks like they're going to be the winners. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. This one fielded at the 5.
What the fuck is that?
And a nice job there on special teams as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
Just like I showed earlier. The Khalil Mack. Scoot him all the way out. That guard on the left side didn't go into the middle.
Okay. One final try now for Bortles. And he can't hang on to it. That would have sealed him.
I wish I was fine. You want to try to go this way?
Look. So after all of this, it comes down to one final play.
And just think of what it's going to be, because
from this
distance, you got to be prepared for everything. Hook and laterals, tip balls, you name it. A lot of laterals.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Duke Dawson picks it, and the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line.
Get the money to my butt, you know.
All right.
Give my baby 30,000. taking to go. I'm gone. A lot of these are lost. They broke. They think it's my fault. No call. I want that cost. I'm tripping. I'm stuck with the sauce. But she love you, don't cut your... Reynolds and Vinci is white. Limited Louis, that's light. Right from the city, that's light. LED, look at the light. We the ones don't like. But you look light. Why even play with your light? Bank account looking like yikes. I'm filling out guys. Supporting my block. Look what you swear to dress. Somebody give me a... These ain't like the cops. Gossiping more than a... In jail I had... I make you get off the... Think that I made it, they can't be my friends, so they wanna be out. If I see them playing, then I'm in that spaceship, I'm dropping the top. Ain't like my beat, ain't no heavy, belated, I'm calling the block. Who gave you a voice? Who told you your thoughts go? Keep me straight to the money. I put my... They call me up. The big Mickey Mouse. You posted your at 12 and 8, then I see how my... All over the mess. Can't sit on my house. I got a check and to go. A lot of these... Lost. They broke. They think it's my fault. No call. I want that call. I'm tripping. I'm stuck with the sauce. But she love you. Don't cut your... Reynolds and Vinci is white. Limited Louis, that's light. Right from the city, that's light. LED, look at the light. We the ones don't like. But you look light. Why even play with your life? Bank account looking like yikes.
Wait. Me. Boy. Y'all messing with fingers. Yo, it's what, get back, watch you turn to a singer. Get it fighting like the Jerry Springer. All of my was in the back, they like a pogo. No new freakies, they popo. Had a G-Wagon truck turned to Rojo. Find a cable to his neck. One ride down to Soho. One was black and the other was Mexican. Had a like a pollo. Younger than you with a Maybach. Younger than you with a Bentley. Finna got in there gently. Ain't being friends with these. When I was down out of soul had sympathy. Facts. But that's how I go when you broke. Facts. Now I'm out like Mr. This my own. Not gonna lost on these new clones. Then she asked for a loan. Had to laugh, then I told her get gone. Go and get the be on. And no give me not a thing. So I'm spending 90K on my ring. You can see all my pen in my watch. Got my eggs down and walk around with my hand on my. Cause I'm popping and I know you not. And I know you see just how I'm living. You're not happy with life, so you rockin' Reeboks on treetops, getting rock. Got a big band, it's like Sasquatch. Every time you see it, what a no, it's time
I got that chicken to go. A lot of these were lost. They broke, they think it's my fault. No call. I want that cost. I'm dripping, I'm stuck with the sauce. But she love you, don't cut your Reynolds and Vinci is white. Limited Louis, that's light. Right from the city, that's light. LED, look at the light. We the ones don't like. But you look like. Why even play with your life? Bank account looking like yikes. The ops on IG all the time. I get them go live. Wagyu steak, I die. 8 ounce, 255. I can't get funky with two groovy you be.
Alright, Big Daddy Fat Cock's back. Oh, you come on, man. Fuck. Do a draft. Let's do a draft. Y'all. Holy shit, it's ridiculous. Maybe it's white. Damn. Right, I'ma just need to move one of them. Fucking D-tackle or one of those other side. Shit. 50 power? Holy shit. I can't fucking tackle for shit. What the hell? Oh, you holy shit. Where's your luck? Oh, this team's looking fucking trash. Tyrod holy shit. Team I ever fucking drafted, holy shit. the corners up there. Right, who's not playing?
Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. With me, as always, Charles Davis. And, Charles, we look at a matchup like this. It's really the running backs that may take center stage here today.
And in today's football, they're still valuable, not just as runners, but guys who can catch the ball as well. It's really the number of touches that determines things these days.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara, and he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Telvin Smith that time there to make the play.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play. Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Kamara, and he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
On the ground, this is Kamara. Unable to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
What the fuck?
A big pickup there, 20 yards as they convert on fourth.
Every play is supposed to get a player's best effort. But on fourth down, that really increases the stakes, doesn't it? What about that catch?
Heck of an effort picking up the first.
And now that team has to be motivated going forward. They just saw a great effort there. They want to make sure it pays off.
Is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Carr. They locate Walker complete. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. They'll run it here. This is Marlon Mack. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Second down, here's Carr. And right side, Henry's got it. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. First time these two have hooked up this afternoon, and it's a first down.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate. Got the ball down.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. A great play there. An 8-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Elliott good on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Is a new set of downs. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
Green's got it over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A really good pickup of 28 yards. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's L.A. with a football here as we begin quarter number two. They've got a 2nd and 9 to start things out. Play action. It's locked. And his throw is going to be incomplete. 6-time Pro Bowler Randy Moss, the intended receiver. Third down here.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but
They took away Dude.
Every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. This Minnesota D up to the task on the third down pass play. And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and 9. They snap it to Locke. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. Randy Moss, 37 yards. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point try. Goodbye,
Darrow. This game is so fucked. Holy shit.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And he'll be brought down on the 37. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
He did have the touchdown run earlier, but he got to block more than that throughout this game.
Sorry, what's happening?
In fact, I would say that this defense has done as good of a job on him as they have on any runner in recent memory. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs. Incomplete to the tight end Walker, right side. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. On second down, Kamara. And an alley. And the ball is knocked out. The defense will get their hands on it. Going the other way. And they will score.
Is he quitting? He quit off a fumble. I'm pissed. What's up, Batajim? Alright, fuck me, alright. Bro, show us up, Dallas. What's up with you, boy? What's up with you, boy? What's up with you, boy? What the fuck? Fuck. Oh shit, what's up, Intelligent? Well, like, I'm always trying to, I'm saying, like, what's up, but you don't say what's up back, so I'm like. Because, bro, you just joined the party, and what if something changed? What if something changed ever since you left? What if something changed? Exactly, you do. You do do that. I'm like, hey, what's good, bro? I'm like, what's good, man? Or I'll be like, so woo. Bread? I'll be like, bread? Yeah, I'll bust whoever the fuck comes at my fuck. I'll beat the fuck out of people out of school. Well, I'm not out of school, I'm not sure. I got Randy Moss, Luke Kuechly, and Marshall Yanda. Oh, yeah. That's Kyle. This guy has Rod Wilson. Oh, shit. Me and the fucking cock. His name is Fresh Smurf. Yeah. He's not there, dude. I don't know what the fuck he's doing. He got pissed at Dead by Day shit. Alright, fuck you then.
To get this one started, 22 men ready to do battle. It's time to dance.
And that drives. No, it wasn't. He just wasn't there. The fuck?
See that happen? It just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up.
Man, shut up. You were saying? You were saying?
run it now out of the gun. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 10 yards there to start the drive.
Shut up. By about the length of the football for a he's been gone for like half an hour.
There we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Ain't nobody getting water for half an hour.
He said right down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
Yeah, KJ Rager's going to get that way.
Again, a first down carry.
He said that his teammates were shit.
Just what you want on a first down run.
And he played, he played Freddy Cougar.
And it's second and two.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early.
Yep.
Pretty much. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And it goes down. Khalil Mack in there to get him for a loss of five. Off of play action. Lock. Forced out to his left. Now he's going to send this one deep right side. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Eric Kendricks. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket.
Fine, tell you, but get on for it, all right?
Doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. There's a guy learning.
All right, whatever.
Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open.
Got to know the drill, but otherwise, just don't do it.
Yeah, man. Tell you, we'll get on rock, baby. Don't talk to me. All right.
The 27-yard line. The completion for 3 minutes, second down.
And partner, I think that's a great example.
I'm trying to go now, 2K. Don't talk to me.
And down he goes. Brought down a Raider sack. Akeem Hicks in there to get him for a loss of five. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go for his progressions, but instead of getting the football forward, he knew
that he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. Good job defensively. That led to the sack. Val Brees on third down. First catch for him on the afternoon, and it results in a first down. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just stall out the momentum, go three and out. They're able to avoid that there.
And we talk about complimentary football all the time, but I think it's a little bit deeper than that. Defense went out, forced a turnover, gave the ball to the offense. It's now the offense's responsibility to pay that off.
Boy, what the front door?
Hey, you guys got the turnover. We appreciate it. They want to continue their drive.
The front dick?
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Now Breeze, escaping the pressure right. Throw it across his body and it's intercepted.
Oh, shit.
Talvin Smith, and he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10. This is Freeman on first and 10. And this one goes nowhere.
Damn, the way this man knows what the fuck I'm doing, that shit crazy, you know.
It's a loss of five, and it'll be a second and long.
Like, I own that issue. What, dude? Y'all don't say, come on, man. On me, the fuck?
Now a play fake, and it's locked.
Bro, I'm really getting fucking irritated.
Third down.
My balls are really about to get chewed off.
That time, but end up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll fake it. Now Lump. He's going to air it out deep for Green.
Can't see the shadows in my bones.
One thing's for sure, when you get a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you're going to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively.
I still see the shadows in my butt.
So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. I don't think we're going to the INT and then lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
But how about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive.
You said what? I said the book right?
Maybe reward their defense a little bit. I put some points on the board on this
one. Touch me watching Call of Duty. Oh, no, he's watching Fortnite now, man.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the
league. Oh, Dallas. Fucking Dallas.
Run, make plays after the catch and gain that additional yardage.
And using what that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice game.
Michael Bennett's versatility, being able to play any position along the defensive front, allows him to make those types of plays. He finds good matchups and gets into the offensive game.
Because he's cheating, Dallas. Because he's cheating.
For a tackle for loss.
Who, oh, Myth.
At the 28. So they get half of what they needed. It'll be third and six up.
He really did fall off.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of
he's not the Myth we used to know.
It's hard in by Ellington.
He really isn't.
He's finally taken down, and it's
like, what happened to the Myth that was, like, building crazy, doing all that shit? What happened to the best builder in the game? Sorry. Not really. He really isn't. The best builder?
Steps away to his left. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second.
That's playground though. That's playground. That's playground. What happens when he plays in the fucking tournament shit? I'm not saying I can beat him. I'm just saying. You guys are saying he's the best builder. He ain't the best builder. He obviously isn't. I don't know, but not obviously not him. It ain't me. There's obviously, exactly. Exactly, but y'all saying that he's the best.
It up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all.
I mean, I don't give a fuck what they call it. I'm just saying what I think. You know what I'm saying?
Knocking it free and creating something good.
I'm just saying, to me, he really isn't the best, like, builder. Maybe before anyone else learned how to build, but now, no.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. This one up to about the 38. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down. That fits the bill.
Flush to his right. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's 3rd down.
Oh, man. It's the roof. Sure.
Luck looks to throw on 3rd and 1. Flushed out right.
See if we got hat again.
And he's gonna have a 1st down as he's brought down at the 44-yard.
Oh, he didn't get hacked, bro. He got banned.
It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
No, he got banned on YouTube too. Catch a little fucking pussy ass pussies.
Just shy of midfield. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first.
They're white, obviously. They're white people. Yo. Who's listening to that? Not good. Who's listening to that shit?
Back with more after this.
Bro, there's no one near you. Why are you not making that pass? Andrew Luck, you're so fucking trash.
And that takes us from 2nd to 1 down.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go around.
It seems to be the front and the back in pass rush. They've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync. only way to play good defense.
Escaping the pressure right. Man open, it's Moss complete.
And then
first down.
Yo.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try
and
beat people.
In the back,
on the
run,
and then get on his horse. Still accurate, but he throws a nice pass for a first down.
They go play action here on first down. Flush to his right.
What? Oh, I'm pissed. AJ Green, you piece of shit.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to hold it in.
Devontae Freeman. And now the Rams are going to hold things as they run timeout.
No problem.
As they'll talk it over here for a little bit. One third down.
Look on.
And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion. The Raiders into the red zone for the first time. They've got a first and 10 at the 17. Here's Locke. He goes underneath to Freeman. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and it'll make it second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. On second down, Freeman. Break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Jadeveon Clowney there on the stop.
We just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flooring to make the stop before it turns into something big.
On third down, Devontae Freeman. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. And we're going to get a timeout. With 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash, this from 33. And Gano's kick is right through. But now there is a penalty marker on the field, so let's see what this is about. Charles, did I just hear that right? They declined the personal foul. 3 yards, they just declined them.
And I have to think that the official is thinking to himself, did I just hear that correctly, that you declined that one? All I can think of is that someone on the field got confused.
Must have.
It had to, because you're going to take the yards on that penalty each and every time.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Yeah.
Now the Rams offense, they work their way back on the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2, now third down. To throw is Breeze.
The best offenses in the world.
Let's go. Let's go, Joey Bosa. Let's go, Joey Bosa. Let's go. Fucking go, dude.
And that'll lead to fucking shit. And no matter what the situation,
that's fucking sack, dude. Give me that fucking sack, boy. Give me that fucking sack, boy. Give me that sack, boy. Let's go. Come on, let's go.
When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starting in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
A good starting spot for the Raiders as they come up first and 10. They'll run with Freeman here to begin the drive. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
Tough first half for him. Unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
a 10th carry for Freeman. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a 3rd-and-1 situation. Now a handoff. It's Freeman. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be 4th down.
I have to go for this shit. Come on, boy. Come on, we gotta get this first down. You know what I'm saying?
The field, they're gonna stay out and go for it on 4th and 3.
I must, I trust you.
They're gonna go. It's locked. He's got the connection.
Go. Oh, give me that first down.
And he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on 4th. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
They tried to quick hit her inside, but
now they will swallow it up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
Throwing on 3rd down, Luck, flushed out right. And he fires one, but incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. The Rams offense now making the way out to take over. These guys had to punt last time, and it's not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. But guys, just take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and call more of that.
A good pickup there at 22. Well, that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you get a heck of a tight end candidate. Now, that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Again, it's Breeze. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. Anderson loses the football. The Raiders pick it up, and his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Following the fumble recovery, here's Luck, eluding the pressure right. That's caught right side by Anderson. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Luck now on second down. Dancing to his left. This one grabbed by A.J. Green. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing this fourth quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort, the catch, the extra yardage, but you got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
Now Love, followed in by Anderson, left side. Anderson loses the football. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Second down, here's Love. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. Call it a gain of 5. And just like that, it's third down.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But it doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there and get yourself completion.
And down inside the 15 he goes. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now. From the red zone now, Locke. And Anderson's got it. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. That throw good for 4. It's second down. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. On the counter, Devontae Freeman. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. The Raiders on third down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. This time it's 3rd and 3. Now it's Locke. This is caught. Hammering for the
ball. Oh my God.
He loses the football. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. His pass caught at the 4.
Let's fucking go, bro. Let's go.
Down, but he winds up paying for it pretty good. Yeah, the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. It's 1st and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. The Raiders likely going to get out of this with a victory as they take a knee.
Let's go. Take a dub. Let's go. Take a dub. Take a dub.
As they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Take a dub.
And they take a knee.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God.
3rd and goal. This L.A. Rams defense will try to bow up once more. They come out here in the eye. They'll look to run with Freeman. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable
But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Got to feel good about your chances. Get my butts.
Fielded about a yard deep.
Yeah, he'll get across the 20
before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And the Rams now coming out on the field. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
Now Breeze. And down he goes. Brought down a Raider sack. Telvin Smith in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll.
I think normally we talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stat sheet stuffer.
And the interception earlier, now a sack. But he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's going to go for it.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a
third
down.
Let's go.
One final try here for Breeze. He's going to let it fly.
Let's go, GG's.
Dropped it incomplete. Well, there's a metaphor for how this one is gone as time has run out on this ball game. So Charles are able to complete what so often seems to be elusive, a shutout in the NFL. And maybe what's fitting is they ended the game on the field, that defensive unit on the field. What an exclamation mark.
And probably felt like they could go another 60 minutes without anyone putting points on the board against them. That's the confidence you gain throughout when you're pitching a shutout. And they're going to leave the stadium feeling like they're all 10 feet tall.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we say so long, everybody.
Oh, Dallas. Ah. Let's go, Dallas. That's what we do. We take dub, you know what I'm saying? Wakanda? Yeah, he said Wakanda. am insane. Damn, good. Play some Call of Duty.